After studying this module, you shall be able to understand the physical significance of angular momentum operator in quantum mechanics. You shall also be able to learn about orbital and spin angular momentum, and you'll understand the commutation properties of angular momentum operator. In this module, we'll talk about angular momentum operator, and we will try to understand why do we require angular momentum in quantum mechanics. Classically, angular momentum vector can be expressed as cross product of position vector and linear momentum vector. That is, capital L represents the angular momentum vector and is expressed as cross product of position vector r and linear momentum vector p. Since all the quantities angular momentum, position and linear momentum are all vector quantities, these in Cartesian coordinates can be expressed as, that means total angular momentum L can be expressed as sum of Lx I plus Ly j plus Lz k, where Lx, Ly and Lz are the angular momentum vectors in the three directions x, y and z, and I, j, k represent the unit vectors in the respective directions. Likewise, the position vector r can be expressed as sum of x, I plus y, j plus z, k, where x, y, z are the position vectors in the respective directions. And similarly, linear momentum can be expressed as sum of p, x, I plus p, y, j plus p, z, k. Taking into consideration the Cartesian coordinates, cross product of linear momentum and position vector gives angular momentum vector, which is expressed in terms of 3 by 3 determinant. In the first column, we have the unit vectors I, j, k. In the second column, we have the components of position vector x, y, z. And in the third row, we have linear momentum vectors px, py and pz. Solving this 3 by 3 determinant gives us the components of angular momentum in x, y and z axis, which is as Lx, that is the angular momentum in x direction, as y into pz minus z into py. Likewise, we get Ly as z into px minus x into pz. And similarly, Lz is obtained as x into py minus y into px. It is important to note that the direction of angular momentum is always along the axis perpendicular to the plane of rotation. That means if the object under consideration is in the yz plane, then the angular momentum is directed towards x axis and so on. And with this, the magnitude of angular momentum is obtained by taking dot product of L, that is the angular momentum. L dot L gives L square, which on solving gives Lx square plus Ly square plus Lz square. It is important here to note that the magnitude is a scalar quantity. Now, we come to the next important topic. Up till now, we have discussed angular momentum, but in quantum mechanics, we encounter two types of angular momenta. Number one, orbital angular momentum, denoted by capital L, which is due to the circular motion of the object under consideration through space and is analog of classical angular momentum. And the second is spin angular momentum, denoted by capital S, which is an intrinsic property of the system under consideration and is unrelated to any sort of motion or with any classical significance. The total angular momentum, denoted by capital J, is taken as sum of spin angular momentum and orbital angular momentum. So now, students, as you already know that for any measurable or observable property, there is a corresponding quantum mechanical operator. And so we have angular momentum operator. So the classical definition of angular momentum is carried over to quantum mechanics by replacing the coordinates and momenta in the classical equation by their corresponding operators. So in terms of operators, Lx, that is the angular momentum operator in x direction, is expressed as y into pz minus z into py, Ly as z into px minus x into pz. And similarly, Lz operator is expressed as x into py minus y into px, where x, y and z operators are the components of position operator, R and Px, Py, Pz are the components of linear momentum operator P. Now after discussing the angular momentum components X, Y and Z, we now define the operators for position and linear momentum components. Classically, the position vector is represented by X and its quantum mechanical operator is represented by X caret, and it involves the operation of multiplication by X. Likewise, for classical quantity Y, the quantum mechanical operator is represented by Y caret and it involves the multiplication by Y. And similarly, for Z, the quantum mechanical operator is Z caret and again it involves the multiplication by Z. And now we come to the linear momentum operators Px, Py and Pz. The quantum mechanical linear momentum operator in x direction is represented by Px caret and is equivalent to minus iota h cross del by del x. Likewise, operator Py is equal to minus iota h cross del by del y, and similarly Pz operator is equal to minus iota h cross del by del z, where h cross is equal to h by 2 pi and h is Planck's constant with a value of 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34 meter square kg per second. Now, after discussing the Cartesian components of linear momentum operator and position operator, we now substitute the quantum mechanical operators for Px, Py and Pz and X, Y and Z into the Lx, Ly, Lz operator equations that we have already defined. With this, the equations modified to Lx is equal to minus iota h cross within brackets y into del by del z minus z into del by del y. Likewise, Ly is equal to minus iota h cross z del by del x minus x del by del z. And similarly, Lz is equal to minus iota h cross x del by del y minus y del by del x. Now after defining the angular momentum components Lx, Ly and Lz, we now come to the question that might arise in your mind, what is the relevance of angular momentum in quantum mechanics? Why at this point of time we are discussing angular momentum in quantum mechanics? One thing we are already aware of is that quantum mechanics is used to study the properties of chemical systems. Now, in order to calculate the properties of a chemical system under consideration quantum mechanically, the first step involves writing the Hamiltonian for the system. This Hamiltonian expression sums up the contribution from kinetic energy of all nuclei, kinetic energy of all electrons, electron nucleus electrostatic attraction, electron electron electrostatic repulsion and nucleus nucleus repulsion. This makes the complete Hamiltonian quite complicated with many terms. Even for the simplest molecular system, that is hydrogen atom, the solution of the Hamiltonian turns out to be mathematically quite complicated. Hence, it becomes difficult to solve for eigenfunctions of Hamiltonian, which indeed determine the properties of the chemical system under consideration. So, a general approach is required to solve this problem. It is already known to us that if any two operators, say A and B, commute, then their properties can be determined simultaneously and exactly. In other words, if operator A and operator B commute, the eigenfunction of operator A will also be the eigenfunction of operator B, which means that operators A and B share simultaneous eigenfunctions. If one finds an operator that commutes with Hamiltonian and is simpler to operate than Hamiltonian, then one can solve for the eigenfunctions of simple operator first. This way, one obtains the eigenfunctions of the complex Hamiltonian. For this, what is required is a suitable operator that commutes with Hamiltonian. One such operator might be linear momentum of the system. Linear momentum of the system is conserved. However, linear momentum operator does not commute with Hamiltonian. This is because Hamiltonian is expressed as sum of kinetic energy operator and potential energy operator. That is, H caret is equals to T caret plus V caret, where T caret is the kinetic energy operator and V caret is the potential energy operator. In terms of linear momentum, kinetic energy operator is equivalent to P square by 2m, where P is the linear momentum operator and m is the mass of the system under consideration. That means the commutation of Hamiltonian with linear momentum operator can be expressed as sum of commutation of kinetic energy operator and linear momentum plus the commutation of potential energy operator and linear momentum operator. Since T is a function of P, as we have already seen, this implies that the commutation of T caret, P caret is 0, which means that kinetic energy and linear momentum commute. Now, the other commutation relation is between potential energy operator and linear momentum operator. Now, as we already know that potential energy of a system is a function of its position, and from Heisenberg's uncertainty principle, the commutation of position and momentum is non-zero. That means the potential energy and linear momentum cannot commute. They do not commute because of Heisenberg's uncertainty principle. And it is for this reason the Hamiltonian does not commute with linear momentum operator. The other choice of operator can be angular momentum. The total angular momentum of the system is conserved and it is known to commute with the Hamiltonian operator. Thus, the theory of angular momentum is relevant as the angular momentum operator commutes with the Hamiltonian, which means the eigenfunctions of angular momentum operator must also be the eigenfunctions of the Hamiltonian operator. Now, before solving the eigenfunctions and eigenvalues of angular momentum operator, we'll first derive some important commutation relations between angular momentum components. The quantum mechanical operator for the components of orbital angular momentum are given by the equations Lx, as we have already defined, minus iota h cross y del by del z minus z into del by del y. Likewise, Ly is minus iota h cross z del by del x minus x del by del z. And similarly, Lz is equivalent to minus iota h cross x del by del y minus y del by del x. Now, since angular momentum is defined as a product of position operator and linear momentum operator, we'll first check the commutation of position and linear momentum components. Case 1, the commutation relation between position operator x and the linear momentum operator px, which is equivalent to x px minus pxx. Substituting the value of px, we get x caret comma iota h cross del by del x. On expanding, now we get minus iota h cross x into del of fx upon del x plus del of x into fx upon del x, which on simplification gives minus iota h cross within brackets x del of fx upon del x minus x into del of fx upon del x minus fx, which is equivalent to iota h cross fx. So, this means that the position operator x and px, the linear momentum operator in x direction, do not commute. That means the position and momentum of the system under consideration in the same direction cannot be determined simultaneously with precision. Now, we come to case 2, where we consider the commutation of position operator x with linear momentum operator py. Substituting the value of py, we get iota h cross del by del y, and operating on a function, we can expand the expression as minus iota h cross x into del of fx comma y upon del y plus del x into fx comma y upon del y, which is equivalent to minus iota h cross within brackets x into del of f x comma y upon del y minus x del of f x comma y upon del y, which is 0. This means that the momentum along y axis does commute with position operator in x direction. Now, with this, we come to the derivation of commutation relations between components of angular momentum operator. Case 1, over here we consider the commutation between the angular momentum operators in two different directions, Lx and Ly. On operating function f, we get Lx Ly minus Ly Lx f. Now, we will first solve the left hand side term Lx Ly f. Substituting the values of Lx and Ly, we get minus iota h cross y into del by del z minus z into del by del y into minus iota h cross z del f by del x minus x del f by del z. On solving this, we get minus h cross square within brackets y del f by del x plus yz del square f upon del z del x minus yx del square f upon del z square minus z square del square f upon del y del x minus zx del square f upon del y del z. Now we solve the right hand side term ly lx f. On substituting the values of ly and lx, we get minus iota h cross z del by del x minus x del by del z into minus iota h cross y del f by del z minus z del f by del y. On simplifying the expression, we get minus h cross square within brackets z y del f by del x del z minus x y del square f del z square plus x del f by del y plus x z del square f upon del z del y. Now, substituting the values of the two expressions that we have obtained, which is Lx Ly f and Ly Lx f, into the commutation relation, we get the output as minus h cross square y del f by del x minus x del f by del y, which is nothing but iota h cross Lz operator. These cyclic permutations yield the fundamental commutation relations satisfied by the components of angular momentum operator. That means on further solving Ly Lz, we get iota h cross Lx, and the commutation for Lz Lx is equivalent to iota h cross Ly. It is important to note here that these three commutation relations are the foundation of the theory of angular momentum in quantum mechanics. Any three operators which satisfy the above commutation relations represent the components of an angular momentum operator. Now, after this, we can define the magnitude of angular momentum as Lx square plus Ly square plus Lz square. It is very important to note here that it is L square that commutes with the full Hamiltonian. So now we'll consider the commutation relation between L square and the components of angular momentum. Very firstly, we'll study the case of L square Lx. On substituting the values of L square, we get the commutation relation as sum of commutation between Lx square Lx plus Ly square Lx plus Lz square Lx. Now this on simplification gives Ly into commutation of Ly Lx plus Ly comma Lx commutation Ly plus Lz Lx commutation Lz plus Lz commutation Lz Lx. Taking into consideration the commutation relations between the angular momentum components Lx, Ly and Lz, we substitute the values and we get L square Lx commutation as minus iota h cross Ly Lz minus iota h cross Lz Ly plus iota h cross Ly Lz plus iota h cross Lz Ly, which is equivalent to 0. Now this means the commutation of L square Ly will also be 0 and L square Lz will also be 0. This means that L square commutes with each of its components. That is, it is possible to specify exact value of L square and any one of its components. An interesting fact over here is, in classical mechanics, when angular momentum is conserved, each of its three components can be specifically defined. However, in quantum mechanics, when angular momentum is conserved, only its magnitude and one of its components can be specifically defined. The above commutation relations that we have derived, which is between L square Lx, L square Ly and L square Lz, holds true for both spin and orbital angular momentum respectively. From this module, we conclude that three components of angular momentum operator cannot be defined or measured simultaneously. Only the total angular momentum, that is the magnitude, and any one of its components can share simultaneous eigenfunctions, that is, they commute. For instance, if L square commutes with LZ component, then one cannot define the angular momentum components along x and y directions with certainty. There always exists an uncertainty relation for every pair of operators that do not commute. The best that can be done in quantum mechanics is to specify the magnitude of angular momentum operator along with one of its components. Now, coming to the summary of this module. In this module, we defined angular momentum, which is expressed as cross product of position and linear momentum, and also the direction of angular momentum is always along the axis perpendicular to the plane of rotation. Further, we defined the quantum mechanical operators of angular momentum, which are given as Lx, which is represented by y into pz minus z into py, and this is equivalent to minus iota h cross y del by del z minus z into del by del y. Likewise, we defined Ly as z into px minus x into pz, which is equivalent to minus iota h cross z del by del x minus x into del by del z. Thirdly, Lz is expressed as x into py minus y into px, which is equivalent to minus iota h cross x into del by del y minus y into del by del x. We also learned that the theory of angular momentum is relevant in context of that angular momentum operator commutes with the Hamiltonian. We also learned that the three components of angular momentum operator cannot be specified simultaneously. That is, the commutation relation of Lx Ly is equal to iota h cross Lz, and that between Ly Lz is equivalent to iota h cross Lx, and the commutation relation between Lz Lx is equivalent to iota h cross Ly. Further, we also derived the commutation relation between total angular momentum and the components of angular momentum, where we concluded that the total angular momentum and any one component of angular momentum can share simultaneous eigenfunctions, that is, they commute.